Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get...
The shards are getting harder to find.
The shards back. Colford Cauldron.
No risk of Colford Cauldron ever erupting again, they used to say. Guess they were wrong.
Yay, volcano. What could go wrong? Right.
Not everything blew up in the Calamity. Why, Colford Cauldron here blew up way ahead of its time. The cauldron boiled over some 300 years ago.
Whoa.
They say it filled the skies with ash and the lakes with molten rock. If you wanted to survive something like that, you had to learn to adapt.
Really? You, come here.
So in a way, the beasts of the wilds, they're all survivors too.
In a sense, yes, yes. Oh, I have so much energy right now. It's unbelievable. You, come here. You too.
It takes a certain stubborn pride to keep on living in a place like this.
I don't think it's pride. As much as it is necessity.
As for us, we learned an awful lot from Colford Cauldron. That learning led to some interesting inventions. The raw power of the world fell right into our hands.
Ooh, flamethrower.
Can't fault our people for their natural curiosity now, can you?
You can, but doesn't do much, if you ask me.
Playing with the cauldron's fires became an addiction.
I can understand.
Sure, we dusted off a good many secrets out here.
Yes, give me that sweet, sweet stomach.
But we discovered other things we're better off not knowing. Taste the air so hot it sticks to your lungs.
Oh. Really? Still alive?
The unforgiving scent of sulfurous dirt. Sorts of awful things crawling underfoot.
Oh,
You can cook those things, but you can't eat them. Never thought we'd find so much life in all that ash.
A pecker nest, a patchwork of sticks with a lone egg nestled inside. Pickers were hunted aggressively before the calamity, but their numbers never seemed to dwindle. Even now they appear to be thriving. Well, apparently they are a model of success. Yay, more knife bar.
We kept on sifting through the cauldron's secrets anyway. The more ash we swept aside, the more life we found. Places inhospitable as they come. But still, we pressed on.
No, what on earth, Dominic?
After all, when we look down inside Colford Cauldron.
Yes?
Look down through all the smoke and flames. We saw him there, the heart of the world. The heart now laid bare by the calamity.
Really?
We had to have it. As for the kid, he just has to get that shard out of there. Too bad taking that thing woke up every last stink eye from here to Jawson Bog. Biggest stink eye he's ever seen's waiting for him on the other side. And where there's one stink eye, there's always more. The cauldron's tenants all gather up to bid the kid a fond farewell. With a good spyglass, you can still see the cauldron from the city. But all the fires died out. There's nothing left of it. He comes back looking like the inside of a chimney.
Yes. Let me check. Yes. Works. I've got a bath for
you. We're all a little short on friends these days, so that's a welcome sight.
Hey, buddy. This is truly amazing.
They said the wild could never be tamed. If only they could see us now.
We have all the animals.
The culture. A still life of old unwanted keepsakes.
The culture. This hails for sentimental. The sentimental people who pass their precious heirlooms to their friends and children. Who doesn't?
I've asked a lot of the kid, but this is something he's done on his own.
Fire bellows. This is just...
Bow and bellows make a strange and fearsome team.
Mouse, why are you doing this to me? Flame spread wider.
At least it won't get cold around here with that thing around.
Yes.
On the inside, a fire bellows ain't nothing like its more popular air spitting cousin.
No. Tactical stock.
To master the musket, you gotta get rid of the recoil.
Battle grip. Causes knockback.
Don't want that thing leaving your hands until you decide it's time. That ought to make those fangs sink in nice and deep.
Mouse, stop it. Later. Yes.
The shard works like a charm. You can hear the monument's heartbeat again.
Gee. A true memorial grants access to a variety of new vigils in remembrance of the calamity.
The memorial may be finished, but our part is far from over.
Inspiration. Now.
We spotted a pecker carrying a shard to Mount Zan.
I don't care about that right now.
Over there is Camp Dauncey, where the brushers steeled themselves for secret missions.
The secretive brushers explored the finer points of pole arm combat in this training arena. Let's go there. I'm feeling it right now.
And to prepare for the wilds, Caelondia's brushers practice at Camp Dauncey. Had to navigate a maze of pincushions with nothing but a pike.
Ouch.
It's a dangerous test for a dangerous job. Health tonics were off limits at Camp Dauncey. They said they made you weak.
Ooh.
rules said he couldn't use any fancy footwork, just your brains and your pike. Just getting through the course in one piece was an accomplishment.
Wow. Give me more.
The brushers were Caelondia's field agents, and their training was harsh.
Ouch.
You had to find a path through the maze as quick as you could. One well-placed throw could take out several of those ugly critters. See why the brushers prize those pikes of theirs.
Yes. And I'm sorry if I'm quiet. As I said, I'm full of energy. Full of it. Grady Incinerator.
Grady Incinerator is where we sent off all our trash to be burned, or be eaten by the wilds.
Well, let's burn stuff.
Welcome to Grady Incinerator, home of the hottest wings east of Caelondia. In all seriousness, the incinerator was a dump, and it had a problem with peckers.
Really?
Blasted things would swoop in and spread trash all around. Until we started using fire. We couldn't just torch them all at once. We had to use restraint.
Oh, come on.
Keeping the incinerator clean was a paying job. But not a pleasant one.
Second prize. Well, you all get the idea of this. So onwards to the next proving ground.
You'd almost think those peckers like getting cooked.
I just like to get fried alive. Gee. Trigger Hill.
That's Trigger Hill, where the army's elite became the finest marksmen in the land.
Let's do that.
Caelondia's army only took the best, and the best of them trained on Trigger Hill. The Triggers believe they were nothing without their rifles.
Ouch.
Nothing beats the feel of shooting a Caelondian army carbine. Sometimes you had to take care to steady your shot. The Triggers had clearance to modify their guns however they chose.
That's nice.
Some felt the course was too easy, so the Triggers spiced things up a bit.
Really? Oops. Hey!
The kid ain't bad, but the Triggers were better.
Oh, shut up. Just 11 seconds.
His ears must be ringing after all that shooting.
Yep. It's a noisy weapon. What do you expect? It's a sniper rifle! Gee. Proving ground, Trapper Shingle.
That's Trapper Shingle. Only place in the city to go to get certified with a repeater.
Well, let's do that. What could possibly go wrong?
No place better than Trapper Shingle for learning to tread light and shoot straight. Trappers had to tread real careful here, else take a nasty fall.
Ouch.
They train themselves by clearing out the targets while not clearing out the floor. Any good trapper knows never to take a step till the time is right.
I'm a little bit...
Decent trapper wouldn't walk away empty-handed.
Hey! So many more.
To think a rickety place like the Shingle survived, and so little else did.
Yeah. Well, probably because it gave in. Oh, this will be fun.
That's Windbag Ranch. Perfect place to work a blade if you got the stomach for it.
Well, we are doing this now, so might as well. At least show them all.
Windbag Ranch was built for gathering squirt extract in copious supply.
Face
ain't
back.
Nothing more healthful.
Ouch. Okay.
Slippery little devils. Some folks showed up to make a fast buck with nothing but a knife. Other folks came to train their throwing arms.
Ouch.
Still others use the place to test their finest blades.
Come here, you little.
Soon enough.
Yes. Oh, 11 seconds.
No, make it 12. Make it 12.
Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch smelling good and ripe.
Of course I do. I'm a ripe sort of fella. Excuse me. Let's go pistolero.
Slinger range is where the city's quickest pistoliers put themselves to the test.
Onwards.
You have to think fast to survive the wilds, and none thought faster than the slingers. They could shoot their pistols with the speed of a machine.
Faceplant. Wow.
They knew just when to start shooting and when to stop. Those pistols could spit out rounds just as quick as you could pull the trigger. Learning to hold your fire could be its own challenge. Slingers were much quicker than the average pistolier.
Well, then let's do it again.
The slingers could plug you full of holes faster than you could say draw.
Let's do it again. Shift right click.
Slingers like to edge each other out using customized pistols.
I can see why.
Eventually, it all comes down to reflexes. No matter how fast you are, you can always get faster.
Thank you very much. 700 or more. Nope.
Well, even the slingers weren't quick enough to escape the calamity.
True that.
That's a scrapyard, where folks got to smash things and call it community service.
And they didn't upgrade the hammer one bit. Let's go there anyway.
The city's unwanted things all met their end in the yard. Folks who fouled up would do their time here, smashing things to bits. The quicker they worked, the sooner they could go. Folks learned to plant their feet and put their backs into it. Others would plot a course to navigate that sea of junk. A good day smashing could feed a family for a week.
Lesson 27. 12 seconds, it's always 12 seconds. Something wrong. A flake of unusual rock unseen prior to the calamity. Try this at the slightest touch, it feels like bone, only heavier. Okay. Sounds nice.
Ever want to just smash things for a while? You know where to go.
Yep. Nope. I have some vigils.
The brushers. They moved in shadows. But the calamity found them.
The brushers. Caelondia's hidden strength. They moved unseen toward secret causes.
The triggers. My brothers. Bravest men I ever knew.
The triggers, the courage and solidarity of the Hell's Gravel cavalry, was only surpassed by their aim. Interesting. Let's go here. There's here stuff.
It wasn't fixed. It was unbroken.
Dual decider. Now I don't have money anymore. And we have a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. Okay, we can fully upgrade with a more war machete if we have the money. Almost the repeater. Long way off this one. You almost long way off. Also long way off, you. Long way off. Yeah. Oh god. All is way off. Well. I say... Good night and sleep well for now.